same as Canada. It's like saying South Korea is the same as Japan. It's not the same.
So you have to live there to talk about that stuff.
Of course not, but I think seeing the world from, you know, an outside perspective is definitely different. You're going to get filtered information. You're going to get information that the United States wants you to see. You're not going to actually see the bigger picture of what's happening inside the country. Just like before I came to Japan, I didn't know all the issues with Japan until I came here. I only knew the issues that were publicized. And that's all you're going to know, because that's how else would you know any other story other than what your country has said.
But Nobita used to live in Canada, and there are a lot of black people living in Canada. And number two, Nobita speaks pretty good, you know, fluent English, and he said he was staying in New Orleans for a while. And someone, you know, anyone saying that you can't have an opinion because you never lived in a certain country, a certain region, is a nonsense situation. That's like, oh, if you're an American person, you shouldn't be talking about Middle East conflict because you have never been to Middle East. Does that make sense? So it's nonsense argument. And
nothing you can't talk about, you're free to talk about. But know that your information is definitely limited and biased because of the way you're going to receive it.
Yeah, but as a person who used to live in America for years, I have met 13 sexual offenders in my life, in my entire life. Okay? So one was Latino, okay? Two was a white man. Two was a white man. And four was an Asian. And the rest was all black. So am I lying? Am I bullshitting right now? I don't think I'm lying. Because I'm telling you from my personal experiences that when I was living in West Coast America, I was almost raped. I was almost killed by a black man. Intruder came into my apartment. Well, my apartment was very, very fancy apartment in a hills area with a security guard, 24-hour security. They had a doorman and everything. And I had a garage, right? But it takes 30 seconds to close the garage. So you use your remote control to open your garage, get inside, but it takes 30 seconds to be closed. And that 30 seconds, in that moment, giant black guy, 6'3", tall black guy, very old, middle-aged guy, who was wearing a long coat jacket, right? Kind of looked like a Sherlock Holmes jacket, right? And I didn't realize him because I was inside of my car and my parking was like huge and very big, right? And I got off my car and I opened the trunk. I was trying to get my grocery out and I heard a noise, dun. So I looked back and there is a tall 6'3" black man standing. And I was like, who is that? Because I was living in a white neighborhood and I was the only Asian chick in the whole building, right? And this giant black guy, 6'3" black guy, and like I said, there's only two black people living in my apartment building. One was a black woman and one was a producer guy, and I know both of them. So I was like, hey, do you live here? I said to him, do you live here? And he didn't answer anything. But anyway, my parking was so big and huge. There were at least like 100 meters from garage door, the main garage door garage gate to my parking place, okay? Around 100 meters. I would say 85 meters. Yeah, it was very far. But I have a very good vision, and I could see the guy coming slowly and slowly. And he didn't answer my question. Do you live here? And he didn't answer my question. And he all of a sudden opened his, he took off his jacket's button, right? And he starts winking. He starts pleasing himself. And yeah, he starts pleasing himself with his right hand. And left hand, in his left hand, he was holding 9-inch kitchen knife. And he was coming slowly and slowly, and I was like, oh my god, right. And I had a elevator on the right next to my car, but my apartment building was very secure. I had to insert the key to get my elevator back to my garage area. And the elevator was coming slowly, slow and slowly from 15th floor. And he was already coming to attack me with a 9-inch kitchen knife. And so I changed my mind. You know what, if I wait for the elevator to come, I'm going to be stabbed and killed and raped by this guy. So I immediately changed the course. I went back to my car, opened the trunk, got my 2 Fiji border water, actually. You know, Fiji water, they have like smaller version and a medium version and a big large one. I had the largest Fiji water bottle, right? And a Fiji water bottle is very hard texture. They are made by plastic container, plastic bottle, but it's much harder than crystal geyser. So I had a baguette in my, because I came back from grocery store, I had a baguette, right, the French bread, and a Fiji water bottle. And I said to myself, I'm gonna beat the shit out of this motherfucker, right? Because he was already naked, wanking his penis, standing. While he was standing and jerking off his dick, and he was coming slowly and slowly. And like I said, my apartment, it was very secured, so the outsider cannot get in. It was a very fancy apartment with a full security and everything, so a stranger cannot usually get in. But it, like I said, it takes 30 seconds to close the gate, and he came in, and he looked like he's a homeless bum, you know, homeless dude, he homeless looking guy, right? But since he had a knife, and he was already wanking and jerking off his dick, my mind is, if I don't beat the shit out of this motherfucker, I will be killed. My natural instinct, right? And I look around, I tried to call the security, but security at the time was on, she was outside. He was standing outside the main gate. He was not looking around the garage area, because I had only one bodyguard, I mean one security guard in my apartment. So anyway, so since I grew up in dojo since I was a little kid, I'm not like one of those, you know, pussy, because, like, you know, Americans, Asian girl stereotype is like shy, quiet, docile, you know, type pussy, tiny, petite, short, whatever, right? So that's why Asian girl or Latina or Native American in general are way more targeted than 6 feet tall giant white woman when it comes to rape situation in America. Yeah, that's why I'm a pro-gun person. I'm a pro-gun person. I don't know, you know, I used to be a liberal Democrat, but I don't know about that after the Harvey Weinstein incident. I don't agree with everything what Democrat or leftist left people say, and they are saying that Second Amendment should be changed or stuff like that. I don't agree with that. As a former rape victim, as a person who had a 13 sexual offender I had to deal with in my entire life. So for that matter, I do not agree with social justice warrior. And I'm not saying that all black people are racist. I'm not saying that all black people are rapist. But I'm telling you from my personal experience that I was almost killed by a 6'3" tall black man. So am I a racist for saying the fact? Am I a racist for saying the truth? I don't think so. Anyway, so I was like, I'm gonna beat the shit out of this motherfucker, right? And I grew up in dojo. I was told that anything can be a weapon, like fork can be a weapon too. pencil can be a weapon too. Anything can be a weapon, right? So I beat the shit out. I got a bucket in my hand, and I threw a fucking bucket at him, like more like beat him up like a baseball bat, because bucket, a French bread, is a very hard texture. So if you beat him like really hard, so I beat him, and he dropped the knife. I took the knife, and I'm gonna beat this motherfucker up, right? But before I beat him with a bucket, I had a Fiji water bottle, and I was swinging my Fiji water bottle like I'm gonna beat this motherfucker up, right? And he was a little bit hesitant, and I noticed that this guy is a pussy. I think I can beat the shit out of this guy. Why? Because if you're 6'3" tall black man, you don't need a knife to rape me. You don't need a weapon to rape or physically assault a short Asian girl, right? So he already has 9-inch kitchen knife to sexually molest me. It means he's a fucking pussy. That shows everything about him. He is a pussy. He's a pussy as Negro. Yeah, that's why he needs a knife. Right. So even though he was 6'3", I was like, I'm gonna beat the shit out of this motherfucker. And actually, I did. And so he just ran away. And he dropped the knife. I took the knife as evidence. Right. And then right after that, security guard came in. Because he heard the noise that I was, you know, I was screaming like a Bruce Lee. Wah! Right? And so, he came in, he opened the door. Because there's like several doors. There were several doors in my apartment building. So, he came in and I screamed, door, door! He's a rapist, door! Chase him! And then he tried to chase me, and after that I asked him, did you get him? And he said, no, he ran away too fast. So, I don't even know the guy's name. I don't even know his address or anything, so I could not arrest him. But I'm still a little bit traumatized by that incident. But that's the thing, if he had a gun, that's another story though. Because he had a kitchen knife, 9-inch kitchen knife, so I could beat the shit out of him. But what if he had like AK-47? That's a different story, right? But there's a lot of thug and gangster in LA, like Crips and Bloods and stuff, and they do have a gun, right? What about if you get targeted? Am I gonna say that, oh, I'm so weak, I'm so weak, Asian girl, please rape me, fuck my pussy? Fuck no. I'm gonna beat the shit out of that motherfucker, right? Because it's a self-protection. Self-protection is not a sin, right? So, I'm not only talking about from my personal experience. Oh, there's another guy, another black guy. As I was driving my car on Western Avenue on Hollywood, yeah, I was waiting for the light. I was inside of my car. The sign was red, right? And there's a homeless looking bum black guy. Miserable, right? He tried to open the door from the left side. And luckily the door was closed, so I did not get molested or anything. But that was the second time I saw a black guy jogging off his dick in a public place. And I said that I met 13 sexual offenders in my life. Because I'm pretty. I'm prettier than average. So if you're prettier than average, you do attract those creepy weird dudes. I'm not trying to be narcissistic. It happens if you're young and, you know, prettier than average. Anyway, so, by the way, that second black guy, he was okay though. Because I was in the car. I was in the car and the door was locked. So I was okay. But not to mention that when I was 18, I was sexually assaulted when I was only 18-year-old and a virgin. And his name is Frederick Morris from Positive Protection. He lives in Japan for, I don't know, over 3 decades, and he is a sexual offender and a rapist in Japan. And he is a big-time party promoter, concert promoter in Japan. He has raped so many young Japanese girls in the past. How could I say, how do you say in English, rapist offender? Who is a racist? Am I a rapist offender? Who is a racist? I don't think so. I'm just saying my personal experience. And also my friend's experience. I had a friend of mine who's Japanese, and she was also living in California. She was going to college over there. And one day she was sleeping, and she felt really heavy stuff on his tummy, and she woke up at the middle of the night, and she saw a giant black guy sitting on her tummy. And she looked outside. She looked at the door, and the door was totally broken. And she said that she was living in the apartment all alone, and she was living in the first floor. So the three gangs came in, broke the window, intruded into her crib, stole her iPhone, her iPad, her computer, and passport, money, everything. Right. So before I left LA, I was trying to sell all my furniture and stuff. And she looked so paranoia. And when I saw her for the first time, she looked very worried. And I was like, are you okay? And before I met her, she told me, could I go to your place with my boyfriend? Is that fine with you? And I said, sure. Right. And she looked so worried and so like a PTSD-ish. And so I asked her, are you okay? Well, like, are you okay? But she looked a little bit like worried and like nervous and stuff. To get in, like before she entered my house, she let her boyfriend to enter my house to make sure everything is okay. Like I'm not lying, I'm not a scam or anything like that. You know, cause I was trying to sell my furniture and stuff. And she said to me about her personal experience that she was robbed and sexually molested by a giant black thug. And I was like, are you okay? Were you raped? And she said to me, no, I wasn't raped. But I'm sure she was lying because she looked so damaged and she had the tears in her eyes. And you know, I'm also a rape victim and a sexual assault survivor, so I know when I see another sexual assault survivor, I'm able to read it. I'm able to tell. Just like if you're gay, you're able to tell another person is gay. You know, it's a sympathy thing, right? So anyway, she told me about her personal story that she was a college freshman year. She was in college. She was a freshman. And she was only 18. Right. So I told her, I gave her advice, never try to get an apartment. You should never live on the first floor. The first floor, in the first floor, no way. Even secure building or anything or something like that, you should never live in the first floor. You should always get an apartment in the second floor or at least the third floor for the security reason, right? So she told me about her personal experience, and I know I met another friend of mine. She was also raped when she was only 18 years old in California by a black man. She says a guy put the drug in her beverage, and while she was in the bathroom and tried to throw up, the black guy came into the bathroom because she forgot to lock the bathroom because she was not in the bathroom to take a pee. She was, you know, trying to throw up, and the black guy came in and he was like, I can help you to throw up. And what happened is she locked the key, and she was basically saying that the guy was trying to force her to give him oral sex, and she refused to do that. And then he put the condom on and he tried to fuck him. fuck her, like sexually molest her, and not even consensus. And so, I was actually there. I heard someone screaming, "Help! Help!" So, me and my two other friends were on the second floor taking an audition, right? Right? He was on the Wesley Snipes movie audition, right? So while I was taking a movie audition on the second floor, my friend who was 18 years old at the time was raped in the first floor, in the bathroom, the toilet, by a Wesley Snipes friend. Young actor, I forgot his name, so he's not really famous actor, but, you know, he was like 25 or 6 year old young black actor who is a friend of Wesley Snipes. And when I heard the sound screaming, I kicked the door and I said, because I heard the noise, like, "Help me, help me," right? So before the incident happened, I look around because I couldn't find my friend, right? And I thought she was gonna be okay because there's like 100 people in the first floor. I thought, you know, who would think that this 18-year-old girl would be raped by Wesley Snipes? Wesley Snipes' close friend. I never thought about it, right? So, anyway, she was screaming, "Help! Help! SOS! SOS!" or something like that. Because, you know, she couldn't speak very good English. But anyway, so I kicked the door. Door didn't open. So I called another black guy, the security guy. "Hey, she was saying that she's being raped in the bathroom. She's stuck. She's stuck. Open the fucking door. If you don't open the fucking door, I'm gonna call LAPD right now." No, I didn't actually say that. I said, "LAPD, open the fucking door." Yeah, I was pretending like I was LAPD. Yeah, so he finally opened the door. And when he finally opened the door, after that, I saw my friend crying, sitting on the toilet floor, and her clothes are half, like, you know, like a teared up and stuff, like, "Are you okay?" And she was crying. And so I tried to, like, push this guy's, you know, this black motherfucker's neck, like, "What the fuck did you just do to my friend?" And he was fixing his belt, and yeah. So that's it. And are you still gonna say that black people do not commit the crimes? Are you still going to say that all... Here's the thing, I'm not saying that all black people are rapists. I'm not saying that all black people have low IQ. I'm not saying that all black people are dumb and stupid and commit the crime. Absolutely not. One of the most successful high IQ minority in America are Nigerian. They are 100% black. They are more darker and blacker than black Americans. So this is not a black issue. This is more like a black American issues, right? And I have spoken to many black people, all types of black people, because it's like, you know, black French, black Italian, black British, you know, black Caribbean, black Jamaican, to black from Africa, right? But I think Nobita is mostly talking about black American issues, and he is aware of that fact, and he's just talking about that fact. It's the fact that there is a black on black crimes going on. That's the fact. Don't deny it, because it's the fact. I know two of my black friends were shot and killed by another black gang member, and those two black guys are not even in a gang. They were both like, well, one was not a college student, but one was like regular black guy. The other one is my friend's boyfriend's cousin, who is a college student. He just got shot by another gang. Right, and he was not even in a gang. Right. So, that's it. Like, a black-on-black crime's a serious issue in America. And those people saying that, oh, if you never lived in America, then you shouldn't have an opinion about... But like I said, that's like people saying that, you know, nobody in the world says that, oh, you're American, you have never lived in the Middle East, so you should never talk about Middle Eastern conflict. Or you never lived in China, so you shouldn't be talking about communism in China. Like, that's nonsense statement. It's a very ignorant nonsense statement. And if you want to say that, oh, the media is twisted, media is a touristy. I half agree with that point, though, because, like, when it comes to black crime rates, well, that's one thing that I don't agree with Nobita, which is American Constitution, when it comes to police investigation, black people are still racial profile. The racial profile does exist in America. It's a serious issue. Yeah, like, white men wearing hoodies, walking down the street, or going to a parking lot of the grocery store, or a black man who is clearly a dark-skinned black guy with a hoodies on, you know, someone who wear very casual clothes, like, you know, like a, someone who looks like a rapper or whatever, and you go in a grocery store or parking lot. Now, your situation is very different from let's say Anglo-Saxon looking white people. And I do understand that there is definitely a racial profile does exist in America, a racial profile does exist in every cases. But what I'm saying is that those political correctness, social justice warrior, they talk like all black people are innocent. All black people never commit to the crime. All black people are saint. Because that is not the fact. And as a former rape victim who was raped by a black man lived in Japan for over 3 decades, I just want to say, you guys just shut the fuck up. Because you guys do not know anything about what people go through. Yeah. Translation for you guys, because you guys are just too ignorant about what's happening in the world. Now, since 1945, there's so many Japanese women being raped by mostly black soldiers. Okay, so how do you answer that question? How do you answer and how do you respond to that situation? For example, okay, I'm gonna translate what I'm reading, okay? Yumiko, okay? Do you know why in Okinawa nobody named their children Yumiko. Because Yumiko was a little child, she was a 6-year-old kid, Japanese girl, raped by a black man in 1955, September 3rd, in Okinawa. Okay, Uruma City. She went to see the movie all alone, and after that, she disappeared. Now, Okinawa summer season, it's usually bright until 8 p.m., right? So anyway, the next day, Yumiko was found dead. So, the black soldier, he was a military serviceman at the time, another black man, right, from America. Because I'm not trying to sound like a Trump, but when they send us American black, they're not sending best type of black people. They're not sending us Neil deGrasse Tyson. They're not sending us master degree, college graduate, educated black men to Japan. They are sending us criminals, rapists. That's the fact. You know, to be an English teacher in Japan, you don't even need college degree. Like, you don't even need to major a linguistic. You don't have to be a linguistic major to be an English teacher in Japan. Anyone can be an English teacher in Japan, right? Let me just put this way, okay? If I had a bachelor degree, and if I tried to get H-1B visa to work in America, okay, to work in America, you need to have at least a master degree as a foreigner, right? So why isn't Japan eliminating those foreigners to come to Japan? And that's one of the reasons why worst kind of foreigner come to Japan and commit to the crimes, especially when it comes to black Americans. And I'm not talking about Nigerian. I'm not talking about black student. Foreign students come from Africa because they are very educated people. But I'm only talking about black Americans. So am I a racist? I don't think I'm racist because, like I said, blacks from another countries are not committed to crime like black Americans. So this is not a black issue. This is not a color issue because they are too dumb and too stupid to see the reality. This is not a black issue. This is not a dark skin complexion, or this is not a dark skin issue. If the dark skin is an issue, then why is a brown person with an Indian person from India a very successful and most worker in a high-tech field in San Francisco are Indians from India, and they have a darker skin than blacks from America? Skin color is not an issue. The truth hurts, huh? Right. So this is not about the color issue. This is more like a black American social structure that they have a victim blaming society. So they want to say that, oh, I'm black, so they're racist. Hey, Nigerian has a better, Nigerian's doing better. A Nigerian has a darker skin color than you. But you don't see Nigerian from Nigeria whining about the stuff black American is whining about. Why is that? Maybe you should learn something from blacks from Africa. Okay. So that's another question. If you think I'm racist, then why is a blacks from Africa hates black American for the same reason? They are saying the black Americans are lazy and black Americans are criminals. And those words are coming from blacks from Africa who has a darker skin than black Americans. Right? And what did I just say? The most educated minority in America are Nigerian, from Nigeria. So anyway, I'm gonna translate these words, okay? So Yumiko, at the time, she was only 6-year-old kid, raped by a U.S. Marine. I don't even want to translate this, this is too much. Raped by a black soldier, and her body was dumped in a trash can. When her body was found, in her right hand, she had several glasses several glasses in her hand, gripping really hard and tight. And her lips were like, you know, 唇をかみしめて. She was like, ugh. She was biting her lips, gripping the glass. So that's why in her right hand, there are several glasses in her hand found dead. Yeah. 1955, September 4th. So am I lying? I'm just reading an article. Right. So, because there were whistleblower, they found the suspect, they found the guy who sexually molested and raped Yumiko, right? So, oh my goodness, okay. So, in September 4th, Okinawan Times article written, of this September in the morning, Cardinal Village in Okinawa, she was found, and her dead body, her anus was completely split, like, it looked like someone stabbed her body and anus to be bigger or tear it up, so her anus was completely like stabbed and tortured and like, yeah, so basically she was raped. 6-year-old Okinawan Japanese girl raped and dead, dumped, killed and dumped into the trash can. Which means the black guy in come to Okinawa, they don't even acknowledge as a Japanese as a human being. 1955. Right. What happened to the guy who raped Yumiko? He was arrested 1 week later, but he didn't get executed. Yeah, because of rape. It's not, you know, the rape crimes in Japan when it comes to even a US military guy make sexual assault, they're not going to be arrested unless the victim is killed as a dead body. As a dead body, they're not going to be prosecuted. Why? Because like I said, most of the time, Japanese culture have slut-shaming, victim-blaming society, so that rape victim cannot come out. So if you go to Okinawa, you see an old woman saying that, I was raped 50 years ago, or I was raped 60 years ago. There's women are everywhere in Okinawa, and most of them, they are done by black marine U.S. military servicemen. So I want to know about your opinion, you fellow social justice warrior. In 1995, September 4th, the same season, the same day? Okay, Yumiko was killed September 3rd. There's another girl, Japanese girl, that was raped September 4th, 1995. Three black American soldiers. Marcus Gill, Rodrigo Harb, Kendrick Slidin. They are all 20 to 22-year-old black men. So this is not America's problem. This is a black American's problem, right? Right? They rented the car in Okinawa, Kunigami, and they kidnapped a 12-year-old elementary school Japanese girl and duct taped her mouth and eyes and raped her. and she was injured physically for 2 weeks because she was also beat up. And what happened? Well, according to Kendrick's lead, Kendrick's lead said, well, I realized that she was too young, so I tried not to rape her, but he was basically bullshitting. He was basically bullshitting because Kendrick Lee went back to America to escape the situation. By the way, those three guys, they are all black guys from America, and they raped a 12-year-old Japanese girl who is a virgin, kidnapped her, and raped her in a car. They only went to jail for 6 or 7 years, and they didn't get executed. America didn't execute those three guys. And what happened to America? Kendrick Lee went back to America, and Kendrick Lee raped a white woman. White college woman in America. And this time, he was like, oh, I can't hide the fact that I raped this white girl. You know why? Because when you fucking rape a white girl in America, white man is gonna lynch you and hang you from the tree. He knew it, and so that's why he killed himself after he killed and raped her. Yeah, but when you rape a Japanese girl, you're not gonna be persecuted or tortured because a Japanese guy slut shamed the Japanese victim, even though the kid is only 12-year-old or 6-year-old kid, and most likely they are going to be dead or killed or traumatized with PTSD. For the rest of her life. So I have a question for those social justice warriors. What do you think about those, you know, situation? Do you still think that all black people are innocent? By the way, for this matter, a guy, U.S. Marine soldier, Richard Mackey, he said that, oh, you could have purchased a woman with the money you guys spent for the rental car. And U.S. military, after that, gave him a layoff because he made a speech like that. By the way, I'm going to read the whole rape situation, okay? 1947, 17-year-old girl raped. 18-year-old girl raped. 1948, 18-year-old girl sexually assaulted, raped. 17-year-old girl kidnapped and raped. 18-year-old kidnapped and raped. 17-year-old kidnapped and raped. 1949, 14-year-old girl, Japanese girl, raped. 16-year-old girl almost raped, and she was attacked and hurt. 9-year-old baby raped. 18-year-old raped, 15-year-old raped, kidnapped. 17-year-old Japanese girl who was working in a U.S. military base as a maid, raped. 1950, Japanese high school student raped. 1951, 16-year-old Japanese girl raped. 1952, 18-year-old girl, she refused to have sex with a black guy, and she was physically attacked. And almost, you know, attacked and hurt it. 1953, 6-year-old girl, raped, murdered. Her name is Yumiko. Do you realize this certain pattern? Okay, because... Okay, I'm gonna keep on reading. 1955, 6-year-old kid, raped, murdered. 9-year-old, raped, almost... killed, but you know, she was basically hurt physically. 1968, 17-year-old U.S. military maid, probably a waitress or something, raped. 1970, Japanese high school attacked, sexually assaulted, for rape purpose. 1971, Japanese junior high school raped. So 1974, 17-year-old girl, 1975, two Japanese middle school raped on a Japanese beach, Okinawan beach. 1985, elementary school girl raped. 1988, 17-year-old raped. 1993, September 8th, 14 and 15-year-old girl raped. 1995. U.S. military servicemen kidnapped three elementary school. I've already mentioned about that incident. Yeah, 1995. December 1995, 14-year-old girl raped. 2005. Elementary school, Japanese girl, sexual assaulted. Do you understand that 99.9% of these incidents all done by black Marine or black military servicemen came from America? Since 19, well, it's written, you know, this is the information I got from 1947. But if you include right after 1945, it will be more than 5,000. More than 5,000. So, I want to know you guys' opinion about these things. Years ago, this guy named Kenneth Franklin, 32 years old at the time, he was a black man, came from America, raped Japanese girl. He hit Japanese girl head from behind with a stick, and then he stabbed her neck multiple times and killed her and raped her. He took her entire teeth out and scraped her entire fingerprints. 10 fingers. You have 10 fingers, 10 fingerprints, right? He scraped the entire fingerprints with a knife. So it takes a while for police officer to investigate. Now this guy has a last name, Shinzato. Why? He married a Japanese woman, and he has a biracial child, baby. And his father-in-law purchased a house for him. So he is basically a bottom-of-the-barrel gigolo type, right? His Japanese wife, his Japanese wife's father bought him a house, a fucking house. Because he was too broke to buy his wife a house. So he's basically a bottom of the barrel loser. Right. And not only that, he killed 20-year-old Japanese girl in Okinawa. Yeah. This girl was raped and killed when she was only 20-year-old girl. She's dead. Rest in peace. So, you know, Kenneth followed her and killed her and raped her, even though he has a wife. So what kind of life was he having? He's from New York. He's from a mother, you know, wedlock lifestyle family. The typical broken black family. And he was bullied when he was 11 years old, and he stopped going to school, which means he didn't even go to middle school and high school. He joined the Marine Corps since 2007 to 2014. He was a huge anime fan, and he was like, you know, black weeaboo. He was a huge anime manga fan, and yeah, black weeaboo killed a Japanese girl. And according to my research, he said he had a fantasy to rape Japanese woman, because you know there's a lot of rape Japanese porn out there, hentai porn out there. So if you're young Japanese girls, you have to be really careful though, because there are a lot of foreign guys out there who fantasize about having sex with a Japanese girl, because the Japanese weird porn is very popular worldwide, and there are some porn category called Asian girl porn or Japanese girl porn or hentai porn or rape porns out there. So there are some creepy guy bottom the barrel foreigner type. They would try to target Japanese girl because Japanese girls are shy and quiet and they don't speak English. So that's why Japanese girl are most likely to be targeted than Chinese or Korean girls, because the Chinese or Koreans are more opinionated and they are more like bossy, I would say. They are a little bit bossier than Japanese girl, and Japanese girls are usually very nice and friendly. But if you didn't know about this situation and you try to be nice, then you are going to be raped and sexually assaulted, or the worst scenario is you're gonna be dead at the end. So, oh, am I making this up? Yeah, I'm just showing you guys this rape victim who are now murdered and dead. Okay, so you know, like to hear your opinion. Okay, I'm gonna read another, you know, article. Former Marine accused of killing woman, self was trying to start anew. So I just told you, Kendrick's Ledit. I think his name is Kendrick's Ledit. Kendrick's lady kidnapped 12-year-old Japanese girl, duct taped her mouth and eyes. Three black guys raped one Japanese girl. Can you imagine that? Where is she at? She's not coming out because she was only a 12-year-old girl. She's still alive. She's still somewhere in Okinawa for sure, but she's not speaking up. So I'm speaking up for her. She probably doesn't speak any English. So I'm speaking up for her, okay? Now, that Kendrick's, the fucking rapist, who was saying at the time, I didn't rape her because she was too little, so I hesitated. I was just pretending like I was raping her, but I didn't actually rape her. And his mother was also very protective. Oh, my son would never do that. Japanese people are so racist because those three are all blacks. So Japanese people just trying to be racist. Okay, social justice warrior, read this. Former Marine accused of killing woman, self was trying to start anew. Okay, article written in 2006. Not too long ago. So, he was convicted with two other US Marines of raping a young Japanese girl. Kendrick's lady tried to put Okinawa behind him by starting anew in his native Georgia, his sister said. Yeah, most rapists who raped Japanese girls, they go back to America and have a regular life like a regular human being. That's the most fantastic things, right? Because Japanese girls are too quiet, too shy to speak up. Hey, you met the wrong bitch to fuck with. Okay. Anyway, so Kendrick's lady tried to put Okinawa behind him by starting anew in his native party with Georgia, his sister said. That all ended this month when Reddit killed himself after allegedly strangling and raping a co-worker who happened to be a white girl. Oops, this time it's wrong because it's not a Japanese girl. If you rape a Japanese girl, you're gonna escape and you'll be free. You can have a regular life. But if you rape a white girl in America, That's right. And there was a house Negro in his head. He already knew that he can escape when he rapes a white woman in America as a black man. And on the other hand, Japan is a dream country for black rapists. Because, you know, those social justice warriors say, oh, Japanese people so racist. I didn't rape the girl because she was too little, so I didn't rape the girl. This is not true, according to Kendrick's legit. Okay? Legit or legit? I don't even know how to pronounce his last name. Then how come he killed a white woman in Georgia and raped her? Because Kendrick is nothing but a bullshitter. He fucked a Japanese girl who was a 12-year-old girl virgin, kidnapped her and raped her, pretending like he was innocent. I'm a good Christian, bullshit, right? So anyway, he came home to get a fresh start. His 42-year-old sister, Kim Bashar, said he wasn't going to let what happened over there come back with him. He wanted people to accept the new person that he came home to be. Lede made headlines in September 1995 when he was among three Marines accused of raping a 12-year-old schoolgirl in Okinawa, a crime that sparked mass protest against the U.S. military. All three were convicted. By the way, I'm not a U.S. military. I'm not anti-U.S. military, but I am bottom of the barrel black soldier. I am anti-bottom of the barrel black soldiers. Because they are all raping children. They are all raping children. I just showed you the data right here. You see, these are all 17, 18, 6-year-old, 9-year-old. All under 18 girls. 14-year-old girl. Why are they targeting a little younger Japanese girls? Because they are helpless. I was also 18 when I was raped. So fuck you. Anyway. Go back to the story. Reddit made a headline in September 1995 when he was among three Marines accused of raping a 12-year-old elementary school girl in Okinawa, a crime that sparked mass protest against U.S. military. All three were convicted, and Reddit was sentenced to 6 years in prison. Just 6 years. Okay, if you rape a white woman in America, you're gonna go to jail for 59 years, 60 years. But if you rape a Japanese girl in Japan, you go to jail for 6 years only. What kind of bullcrap situation is this? You see, Japan and the U.S. made a treaty. They made a treaty, that's why. If U.S. military servicemen make some kind of like sexual crime in Japan, Japanese police has no obligation to arrest those people. Yeah, you have to go to American court system to sue those guys. Yeah, it's complicated. It's so much more complicated. So unless you get killed and your body is dumped on the street, the rapist is not going to jail. So I have a greatest message for all these rape victims' family. You should be happy that your kid is raped and killed. You know why? Because if you didn't get killed, You have to live your life with pain for the rest of your life. And there's tons of Japanese girls who are raped virgin by a black ex-military guys in Japan, including myself. So thank you so much. Anyway, Bashir said her younger brother never talked about what had happened, but she had always hoped he would one day talk to her about it. Police in Kenesaw, a suburb north in ATL, said the 31-year-old legit strangled 22-year-old college student. He's a fucking pedophile. Lauren Cooper, sometimes during the weekend of August 19th, before slitting the arteries in his own arms and bleeding to death in her apartment. This guy was a 31-year-old, didn't have a car. Totally a loser. There was evidence. Well, you know, Lauren Cooper was saying that her co-worker, Kendricks, didn't have any car. 31-year-old live in Georgia and doesn't have a car. Try and count on 22-year-old college student to drive a car to get him to go somewhere. I don't know what happened. But she was found in her apartment dead, tortured and raped. There was evidence Cooper was sexually assaulted before she was killed and hit in the head, said Brian Frist, a Cobb County medical examiner. Okay, so there's evidence. You can't lie. You can't lie anymore, Kendrick. You raped Okinawan 12-year-old girl, raped a virgin, and you tried to escape that situation because you're a fucking criminal, bottom of the black guy, right? And then moved back to Georgia, raped a white woman, college student, 22-year-old college student. Now, this is crazy. So, he basically sexually assaulted before she was killed and hit in the head, said Brian Frist, Cobb County medical examiner. Police are continuing the investigation and awaiting results from the autopsy. Officer Scott Luther of the Kenesaw Police Department said. Bashar said, who is his sister. Some of the leaded friends have told her that he and Cooper, a junior studying marketing at Kenesaw State University, were friends who left a party together on the night of August 18th to go back to Cooper's off-campus apartment together. A manager at Zucca Bar and Pizzeria in said Ledger and Cooper worked together there and said that Ledger was a nice guy but declined to comment on their relationship. Cooper's parents, who live in nearby Woodstock, discovered the bodies in their daughter's bedroom when they went to check on her after they hadn't heard from her for days. That was two nights after the party where Lydia and Cooper were last seen. Her father, Jack, had to kick in the door to the apartment in the gated community. Exactly, that's exactly what I did to save my best friend at the time. She was being raped by a black man. Yeah. She was also raped by a black man and I was trying to help her. Try to rescue her. I had to kick the door because she was screaming, help, help. So this story sounds very familiar to me. So her father, Jack, had to kick in the door to the apartment in the gated community. He said Monday that the family has retained to attorney to further investigate his daughter's death because he disagrees with the way Kennesaw police is treating the case as open and shut, leaving too many holes in the story. Luther said he wasn't aware of the family's complaints and that the case isn't closed. Jack Cooper declined to comment further, referring further questions to his wife's brother, Alan, who said in a prepared statement that Lauren Cooper did not plan for Lydette to be in her apartment. Rather, police told the family the last text message found on her phone was, "I'm stuck with him," apparently because Lydette didn't own a car. Priam said, family member found the phone in Cooper's car, Cooper's apartment, covered in blood, and gave it to police. Priam said, adding the family doesn't know whom the message was sent to or whether other calls were placed around the time of her death. This was no accident, Priam said, adding that his niece was savagely beaten in the head, raped and strangled to death with a forearm on her neck. Well, he's an ex-military serviceman, which means he's trained to kill somebody. It's not difficult for him to, you know, strangled to death. Does that make sense? Beaten in the head, raped, whatever. It's easier for him to do it. He's a big giant black guy. Just like I couldn't push his body when I was raped. Virgin. Right after high school. Same story. Lauren was the type of person who loved and befriended everybody. I was just like that too. This was also her father's flaw. She assumed everyone who was nice to her was a good person with a good intentions. Priam said, Lauren Cooper's funeral was held Saturday at Mount Bethel United. Okay, so she's dead. Bashar, which is Kendrick's sister, said that in the years since her brother returned from Japan, Lede had worked hard to improve his life. Her social justice warrior. He worked in the kitchen at two restaurants, Azuka and at a branch of Houston's steakhouse, to earn enough money to buy himself the BMW. Why didn't he pay money for the rape victim? A girl he raped when she was only a 12-year-old girl. Because he was a selfish person. Yeah, he was a selfish person. He was only thinking about buying himself a BMW. He's a fucking rapist, okay? He had always wanted to move into his own apartment. Later initially entered the Marines. You know, by the way, most rape situations are done by black Marines in Okinawa. Yeah. The Japanese government don't talk about it. They're blind. Lede initially entered the Marines because he wanted to prove to himself that he could earn a place with what he considered to be the most challenging branch of the military, Bashar said. No, the black military, you know, Marine servicemen want to come to Okinawa because you can rape any underage girls. So it's a heaven for a rapist. Because if you rape a Japanese girl, a Korean girl, or a Filipino girl, or girls from Thailand, you're not going to be arrested unless you kill the girl and her dead body comes out. Right, and most rape victims are too scared to come out. Because it's humiliating and embarrassing. So it's a heaven for the rapist. Japan is a heaven for rapists. especially those ignorant black guys who fetishize Asian female. Yeah. Why do you think all these bottom the barrel Negro come to Japan? Because they have a, you know, they can't get a decent, hot, good looking black women in America, right? And Asian girls are submissive and docile, shy and quiet with a type of Z. They don't speak English, so they are quiet. They don't nag and whine like black women. Stereotype. Double stereotype. I met so many black men came up to me and said, I don't date black girl. I don't date black women. Black women ain't she. I only date Asian because they have type of Z. And I had to told it. I had to tell him, get the fuck out of my face. Get the fuck out of my face, bitch. Yeah, racial fetishization. They are pedophile. Pedophile racial fetishized Asian girl because they are petty. They are shorter and smaller. It's easier for them to rape a little Asian girl than a tall black woman, a tall white woman. And black men are scared to rape white woman. Because the worst scenario is if you rape white woman, you're gonna be executed. But if you rape Asian girl, oh, it's okay, you can just kill her and dump her body into the trash can. And you just go back to your country and have a life. And act like you never did it. You never did it. Right? So anyway, Lede initially entered the Marines because he wanted to prove himself that he could earn a place with what he considered to be the most challenging branch of the military. That's bullshit. If you wanted to challenge yourself, you would have gone to Iraq or Afghanistan. Yeah. Why do you think those Negroes go into Japan? Because you could rape a kid. 6-year-old kid, 12-year-old girl kid, a fucking pedophile. That's it. But Sharon said she has fond memories of Christmas Day last year when her brother and other family member came over to her home and they laughed and kiddled around as they set the table and ate dinner. He always tried to make people laugh, she said. But Sharon said, she doesn't understand what could have led her brother to kill Cooper and himself. This is really out of character for him, she said. Bashar said she never met Cooper, but she has been told that she was a great young lady with a great personality. My heart goes out to them, said Bashar. A mother of three grown children, we both are grieving for someone we love. I wouldn't have wanted this to happen to one of my daughters. I pray for them to have strength and I hope they can have some kind of closure. This is total bullshit. By the way, Kendall's lady family was saying that my son was innocent in the whole time. Totally bullshit. If you are interested, read this Washington Post article, Three Servicemen Admit Roles in Rape of Okinawan Girl. Written by Kevin Sullivan, Pulitzer Prize winner. He's a pro journalist, write an article for Washington Post. Yeah, read this entire article. Okay?